G'day, thanks for joining me again. Today we'll be talking about Collins versus the Federal Commissioner of Taxation, a 1996 case in the Federal Court. This is on appeal from the Administrative Appeals Tribunal. Now, in this case, the taxpayer owned three lots of land with a factory on it, and they produced plastics. There was a fourth block of land that the taxpayer used to access that factory. They didn't have an easement or anything on that block of land, but they used it anyway, and the current landowner seemed to be okay with that practice. The landowner of that fourth block, which was the access block, went to sell that land. The taxpayer bought the land. They had it through an option. They put a 20% deposit, paid $20,000, and bought the land for $200,000. At that time, the taxpayer was intending to continue running the factory, and their idea was to ensure that that fourth block of land was not given over to somebody else. But at the time, the fourth block of land, according to a valuer, had a very small value because it couldn't have, it wouldn't allow, you know, residential blocks or anything like that on it. And so it wasn't highly valuable. And so $200,000 was probably about the market rate. A few months later, the taxpayer then decided to sell all four blocks of land, and they decided to sell it at auction. And the auction price paid was $1.43 million. Then the taxpayer, the auction was conducted at fairly, it was done at arm's length. They didn't know each other, the taxpayer and the purchaser of the land beforehand. But then following the auction, the taxpayer suggested to the purchaser that the blocks of land would be made under two contracts. The contract for the fourth block of land, that access point, was to be for $200,000. And the remaining three blocks of land for, I can't quite do the maths, but for the remaining about $1.23 million. The purchaser accepted that and they found that essentially he was indifferent and didn't really care how he bought the four blocks of land. The commissioner, the taxpayer gained a benefit here because the three blocks of land that the factory was on was pre-CGT land. And so what they were essentially trying to do was shift any increase in the value on the fourth block, the encumbrance, the access point, over to the three blocks which had the factory on it. The commissioner took issue with this and issued an amended assessment against the taxpayer of about $157,000. Now, the taxpayer was a husband and wife, and so they split that evenly. And there was also interest and penalties. The taxpayer was arguing that the court should pay attention to the form of the contract and that they were allowed to split it. The commissioner was saying, under a provision called 26AAA1, which of the 1936 Act, which is now no longer in force, was essentially saying that where a transaction was at that the transaction wasn't at arm's length. Now, the court found that the bid of $1.43 million was at arm's length. But what happened was subsequently after is the purchaser of the land became indifferent to how it was structured. The valuer said that the real value of the land was to go and put office blocks on it. And so it valued that fourth block, which the taxpayer had bought for $200,000, the valuer valued it at $357,000. And so the commissioner was claiming that there was an increase in the value there. The court found for the commissioner in this case, finding that the purchase price of $1.43 should be spread across the four blocks. This is interesting when you compare it to the last case. And so in the last case that we looked at, which was Sara Lee Housing, and body care, the court looked at the form of the contract, essentially finding that had the taxpayer properly executed spoken to a lawyer, that they could have saved a huge amount of tax. But the court preferred the form. In this case, the court is not looking at the form of the contract, which was in two contracts to split it, and instead looked at the substance, finding against the taxpayer. Now, this definitely is unfair for the taxpayer, but the reason for this is that generally anti-avoidance provisions will only apply if there is a tax benefit for the taxpayer. There is definitely anti-avoidance, but there is definitely not an anti-overpayment provision that the government has put in. So that is that is Collins versus Federal Commission of Taxation, and it's really a question about apportionment. Thanks for joining me.